Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the Image Toolset series, you've learned how to isolate portions of your images with selectives for image processing. You can use a combination of keyers, masks, 3D data, and even machine learning to break up your image in the Flame 2020 products. Ultimately, you land up with a matte or alpha that constrains the image processing effect. Now that matte is part of the image processing pipeline within the selective and is not available externally. In other words, if you wanted to use the isolation matte outside of the selective, say as a separate render pass to use later in a flow graph, you can't just feed it to the matte output of the image node or the Action 3D compositor. However, in the Flame 2020 products, there is a new SelectiveFX shader that will convert the image output to the isolation matte that is derived using the selective. If you wish to follow along, please create a selective on any media using the Action or Image node, and isolate a portion of the image by any means you choose. So to demonstrate how it works, I have a shot in Action, and the selective contains a master grade selective effects that only affects the legs of the man walking across the screen. The master grade is limited by a keyer as well as a gmask. You can see this matte if you toggle to the Selective Matte Object Viewer with F8. Now, in all honesty, it doesn't matter what effect you have on the selective. We're more interested in extracting this matte out of the selective. Switch back to the result view with F4. To extract the matte out of the selective, select it and using the contextual menu, add a selective effects. In the list, locate the shader called Selective Matte Extraction. When you select it, the matte replaces the image and is now the result output. So it's pretty quick and easy to extract mattes out of a selective. Now let's dig into this a little deeper in order to clarify some points as well as expand on a more interesting example. Go to the output menu and you can see that Action is outputting the selective matte as a final result. If you select the matte render pass to preview its output, you will see that it is solid white. So using the selective matte extraction selective effects, the isolation matte is fed to the composite or beauty render pass and not the matte render pass, which you may normally expect. As I mentioned earlier, this is down to the selective's image processing pipeline and not the Action or Image node outputs. Looking at the comp render pass, you can now take this and composite or render this output wherever you want. This leads me onto a further potential situation. Let's say that you do want to output the final composite as well as the isolation matte from the selective. You can't use the matte render pass to output as discussed. However, it is possible with the following workflow. In order to have the beauty pass as well as the selective matte, you'll use multiple render layers instead of render passes, and then edit one of the render outputs. Select the current render layer and press copy. Next, label the first render layer as beauty, and then label the second render layer as matte. Now the matte render layer will render as is, but you need to disable the selective matte extraction shader for the beauty render layer. So ensure the beauty render layer is selected and switch to the action schematic with either the tilde keystroke or the viewing pull-down menu. Locate the selective matte extraction node and change the Tools pull-down menu to Edit Output. This is mapped to Alt-E. Click on the shader to disable it. This operation is specific to the selected render layer. Toggling between them will show you what is active for each render layer. If you press F4 for the result view and toggle the different render layers, you will see the viewport update with the different outputs from Action. Lastly, going back to batch, you can see the outputs of the node, and you can carry on building the rest of your compositing flow graph. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.